Hey friends, Jennifer here. Welcome back to the podcast. This is Monday Fire, episode number something. I mean, who even knows what day we are in, what week we're in, what month is this? We're somewhere in April in the middle of still being a shelter at home order. Kids have been recently just found out that the kids are not going back to school for the year, et cetera, et cetera. And so, I'm not too worried about the fact that I don't know what episode number this is, because, you know, there's just a lot going on. And I'm guessing that you have a lot going on where you are at also. So if you're listening to this right now, I just want you to know that I appreciate you. So Jason and I were having a chat this week that kind of made me think about doing a podcast episode on this topic. We've got several friends and family members that their job situation has changed in the last, you know, couple of weeks. So they've been furloughed, they've been laid off, they've been let go. They are business owners who've had to shut their doors. Now, listen, we've also got a ton of people that we know who are doing really well. So please don't hear the sky is falling, because it's not. But the truth is that there are people who are really, their world is being turned upside down by the recent situation in our country. And I was on a summit this week with my friend Pete Vargas called Rise Up. And he had asked me to come on and talk to the other business owners about, you know, just to give them something encouraging to make them feel like, you know, rising up in this time right now when things for a lot of people are going sideways. And I said something to Pete that I'd never actually said before. That's the title of this podcast. And I said to Pete, I said, you know, crisis often catapults us into calling. And I had never really thought about that until I like literally really started to think about what I was thinking about. And I was like, that is so true. And I was looking back at my own life and I was thinking about how there's been different crises in my life that catapulted me in a different direction. You know, like prior to my husband, the ending of relationships, there has been a crisis of me being laid off after Jason and I had first gotten married. And it was that laying off from a software development position that I became an entrepreneur. You know, we've had two miscarriages in our marriage. The first was our first pregnancy. And because of that, gosh, I was just the second pregnancy. It robs you of your joy anytime you have a pregnancy, but especially on the first one, because then that's all you know is scared after that. And I write about that a little bit in Fear Is Not the Boss of You. But, you know, after having that miscarriage and then looking into Noah's face, like I didn't want to go back to working out in the painting field again. And it wasn't that it was necessarily in crises, but it felt like crises, because I'm like, what do I have to do? It felt like a crisis between giving up this company that I had just built that was doing really, really well and in, you know, magazines and on television, or, you know, like leaving him and full time and in childcare and going back to work. You know, but that catapulted me into hiring one person to come painting for me, and then hiring two people to come painting for me. And eventually there was eight women who painted for me who were so talented and did the work while I stayed home and raised our kids. I can think about, I'll never forget this one day. I went to the grocery store. This was years ago. I'm not sure if we had Ava yet, but Jason had gone. Yes, we would have. He had gone into real estate, and like 10 minutes after the real estate market crashed, like 10 minutes after getting his license. And those were hard days, because my business in the painting industry was directly connected to the entire real estate industry doing well. A lot of my builders went bankrupt, several of them, you know, just under the strain of it, their company folded. It was a horrible time. And I can remember us maxing out a credit card at $30,000 on a credit card. I rarely talk about that. I should talk about that more. And that crisis of, I'll never forget the day I went to the grocery store and I knew our credit card was maxed and I was going to swipe it for groceries. And I was like, oh my gosh, is it going to go through? And that crisis of knowing we had so much debt at the time, it catapulted us. It lit a fire under Jason and I to not ever live like that again. And so as I was thinking about how I could come on today and give you some sort of an encouraging word, I wanted just to tell you, if you are in the middle of a crisis right now, first of all, big hugs. Second of all, when you're in the fire, boy, it's hot. And I don't want to downplay that at all. But what I want to say to you is I want you to think of and memorize and put up on a post-it note and put it behind where you brush your teeth and do your makeup every day. Two different Bible scriptures. One is from Genesis 50:20, and it's that what the enemy meant for evil, God will turn to good. There's actually a song by Elevation Worship, and it's called A Sea of Victory. So it's the Bible scripture is what the enemy meant for evil, God will use for good. But the actual song is called Sea of Victory. I want you to go over to Shopify, Spotify, whatever it's called. I always have to think it's Spotify. Anybody else get Spotify and Shopify messed up? If so, send me a tag me on an Instagram post, will you? But go over to Shopify, Spotify, see, I do it every time, and look up Sea of Victory by Elevation Worship. It's a beautiful song. So that's the first scripture I want you to write down and memorize and stare at it and cause yourself, stir up in you enough faith to believe that, that regardless of how much in the fire you may be right now, that God will, the enemy's trying to take you out, but God's going to use it for good. The second scripture is that all things work together for good for those who are called according to his purpose. That's in Romans 8:28. All things work together for good to those who are called according to his purpose. Yes, eh?
Can I go swimming?
You may not go swimming. Rob's in the middle of recording right now.
Can I have a cool walk to me?
Go get sissy. I love you. This is real life podcast recording from home. That was Ari that just came in and asked if she could go swimming. And so I don't want to downplay at all the fact that if you're in the fire, that it is hot. But I want you to just cling to the other side of knowing that God will work all things together for good. All things, all the crap you're going through, all the heat you're currently under, the fact that you're worried about things, you're having to pivot and shift and change, and you are being catapulted into directions you never saw yourself going in. I want you to cling to the belief that God's got this and he's got you. I love that scripture in Job 13 where it says, though he slay me, yet will I hope in him. Yet will I hope on him. So I want some of you today, if you are just feeling like, is this ever going to end? First of all, it is. Second of all, if you're thinking, what, how am I going to get out of this tight place? The Bible actually talks, I would have to look it up in Proverbs, about putting you in wide open places. Let me look up that scripture for you. But I just want you to know today that God's going to use all of this for your good. He really is. And you're going to make it. And we're going to be okay. And if that is not your current situation, I want you to forward this podcast episode on to somebody right now who is in the middle of crisis mode. Because there are people out there who are. And I wish I could wrap my arms around you through a podcast. Not in a weird way, by the way. But just in a, we're all going to make it kind of way. And let you know that crisis often catapults your calling. You're going to be okay, my friend. I also just want to mention as I'm ending this podcast episode, you guys have heard me talking about fear is not the boss of you for weeks now. And we were number one in Christian leadership books yesterday on Amazon, you guys. And I believe number two today in Christian business. And then there was another category, which I can't think of. We also sold out at Target.com. For fear is not the boss of you. And I just want to take a moment just to thank you so much. I appreciate you more than you know. It has been a really tough week to launch a book. I'm not going to lie. It's been hard. And Amazon's, you know, not let a lot of people leave reviews. People are getting their orders just literally canceled from Amazon. I've got, you know, actual emails showing this. They're not able to get a book order to go through. It's been so frustrating. And I want you to know how much my team and I, we appreciate you, how much Jason and I appreciate you. If you've ordered a book, God bless you. If you've ordered a book and been able to leave a review, God bless you times two. Like literally, we appreciate it so much. Times are tough, but we are tougher. And thank God that we serve a God who is not shocked. He's not wringing his hands. He's not trying to figure any of this out. He is sovereign. His word is sovereign and we can trust him. So thanks, friends. We'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.